Students, I welcome you in my channel. I am Sanju Jhazdia, Assistant Professor of English at Government College Ratangarh. Today I am going to explain Wole Soyinka's poem Telephone Conversation. This poem is included in BA Part 3 by MGS University Bikaner, and this is our first stanza. The price seemed reasonable, location indifferent. The landlady swore she lived off premises. Nothing remained but self-confession. Madam, I won't. I hate a wasted journey. I am African. Silence, transmission of pressurized, good breeding. Voice when it came, lipstick coated, long gold rolled, cigarette holder piped. Coat I was foully, how dark. I had not misheard. Are you light or very dark? Button B, button A. Stench of rancid breath of public, hide and speak. So this poem, The Telephone Conversation, is written by Nigerian poet Wole Soyinka. He is the first African to receive the Nobel Prize for Literature. This poem is about a telephone conversation between a white lady and an African man, and the poet shows that the racism in the society. In these lines, the poet has presented a telephone conversation between an English landlady and a black Nigerian man who is the prospective tenant. So the price of the house, the rent of the house seemed reasonable. The price means the rent of the house. Reasonable, logical. The price of the house seemed reasonable. So the amount of the rent seemed reasonable. Location indifferent. Location was indifferent. So the house, the location of the house was indifferent. That is neither good nor bad. Indifferent means neither good nor bad. The landlady swore she lived off premises. The landlady take an oath. The landlady declared. The owner of the house, landlady means the owner of the house. The landlady declared an oath that she lived away from the building. She lived off premises. She lived away from the building. Nothing remained. Now nothing remained. Thus the deal was almost settled. Nothing remained but self-confession. Only one thing remained. That was self-confession on the part of the tenant. And he said, "Madam, I won't." He told her that I hate a wasted journey. He did not like journey should be wasted. So he told her that he did not like to travel in vain and wanted to settle the deal. I am African. He disclosed to her that he was an African. He belonged to Africa. So he was an African. Silence. And then there was silence on the part of the landlady. Silenced transmission of pressurized good breeding. And this silence was due to the good breeding. So he disclosed to her that he was an African, and there was a silence on the part of the landlady. Then it appeared that this silence was due to the pressurized good breeding. This silence was transmitting or broadcasting something that was tried to compel into an action. And this silence was due to the good manners resulting from training or background. Voice when it came. When voice came. Then a voice came from the lipstick coated, from the lips of the lipstick coated lady who was long gold rolled cigarette holder piped, who was holding a gold rolled cigarette holder. So when the voice came, it came from the lipstick coated lips, and she was holding the long gold rolled cigarette holder. Coat I was foully. So coat I was foully, badly. Then a voice came from the lipstick coated lady, and she asked the African in a very bad manner how dark he was. How dark he was. I had not misheard. Now the narrator is saying that he has not misheard. So she asked the African how dark he was, whether he was light dark or very dark. How dark? That landlady asked the question, how dark he was. I had not misheard. He had had that lady in a good manner. Are you light or very dark? And then she asked, whether he was light, dark or very dark, whether he emitted foul smell in his breath of concealing oneself and speaking. Button B and button A. He was shocked at her forgotten manner, so he did not answer. The lady thought that he had not understood the question, so she asked again, that is, he was light or very dark, as of asking him to choose option A or B. Stench of rancid breath of public hide and speak. Stench of means bad smell. Bad smell of rancid breath. Smelling like stale fat. And she was hiding all these things due to show the good manners. So in these lines, the poet tells us that generally English ladies do not like African teenagers. And this poem throw light on racial discriminations. It is a satire in content. So this is our first stanza, and I think you understood it. Now we are heading towards the next stanza. Red booth, red pillar box, red double tired, omnibus squelching tar. It was real, shamed by ill-mannered silence, surrender post, dumbfounded to beg simplification, considerate she was, varying the emphasis, are you dark or very light? Revelation came, you mean like plain or milk chocolate? Her accent was clinical, crushing in its light impersonality. Rapidly wavelength adjusted, I chose West African sepia, and as afterthought, down in my passport, silence for spectroscopic flight of fancy, till truthfulness changed her accent, hard on the mouthpiece. What is that? Conceding, don't know what that is. Like brunette, that's dark, isn't it? Not altogether. Red booth, red pillar box. He could literally smell the stench coming from her deceptive words. She was speaking in a very bad manner. So he could literally smell the stench, the bad smell coming from her deceptive words, and see red everywhere. He was seeing red booth and red pillar box. So everything appearing him full of reddishness. So red booth, red pillar box, and red double tired omnibus, a big bus, squelching tar. Squelching means making a sound like someone or something treading in thick mud. Tar. So it appeared everything red, and around him, ironically, he is the one who is ashamed by the tense and awkward silence. So it was real, but it was reality. It was the factual thing. So red booth, red pillar box, red double tired omnibus, squelching tar. It appeared everything red to him. And as the omnibus, the big bus was squelching tar, it was real. It was reality of the person, shamed by ill-mannered silence. And he felt that it was ashamed on her part, that she was showing ill manners and she was silent. Ironically, he is the one who is ashamed by the tense and awkward silence which follows, and surrender post dumbfounded to beg simplification. So dumbfounded means speechless. Surrender post dumbfounded to beg simplification, and now which follows and asks for clarification, thinking sarcastically that the lady was really helpful by giving him options to choose from. Means, should he choose A or B? Considerate, she was varying the emphasis as she was considering and wanted to ask. He suddenly understands what she is trying to ask and repeats her question. And now she repeats her questions, are you dark? Now she asks him again, are you dark or very light? What type of color is his? He is dark or very light? Revelation came. And in this manner, revelation means revealing something. Revelation came. So now she asked him again, Is he light colored or dark colored? So he suddenly understands what she is trying to ask and repeats her question to her, stating if she would like him to compare himself with chocolate, like plain chocolate or milk chocolate. Would he compare himself with plain chocolate or milk chocolate? So she would like him to compare, if she would like to compare himself with chocolate, dark or light. Her accent was clinical. She was asking in that manner as her accent was very clinical. Her accent was, her approval was unemotional and inefficient, crushing in its light impersonality. And in this manner, pressing with force, crushing means pressing with force impersonality, lacking human feelings. In this manner, she was crushing the human feelings, human emotions, rapidly, means very fastly. Very fastly, she was crushing the human emotions, wavelength adjusted, I chose, wavelength adjusted. She dispassionately answers and his thought change as he describes himself. Then he describes himself, West African sepia. He is of that color of West African sepia. He describes himself as a West African sepia, as it says in his, and as after thought, and then after some thinking, he said, down in my passport, my color is like as in my passport's photo. Silence for spectroscopic. Spectroscopy means very minute analysis. So the lady remains quiet for a while, not wanting to admit to her ignorance, but then she gives into curiosity and asks what that is. He replies that it is similar to fly to Renzi, till truthfulness claimed her assent, and now she wants to understand the truth, hard on the mouthpiece, and now she is hardly catching the mouthpiece, the telephone. What is that? And then she asked, what is that? Conceding. Conceding means accepting. Don't know what that is. Like brunette. Now the narrator is saying, don't know what it, that is. Like brunette. My color is like brunette. Brunette means the woman who is having blonde hairs. So like brunette. My color is like brunette. So he replies that it is similar to brunette, and she immediately clarifies that that's dark, isn't it? Not altogether. That's dark. And now she accepts that he is dark colored. So that's dark, isn't it? She asks the question. Not altogether. Narrator says not totally, not altogether. And now we are heading towards next stanza. Facially, I am brunette, but madam, you should see. The rest of me, palm of my hands, soles of my feet, are a peroxide blonde. Friction caused foolishly, madam, by sitting down, has turned my bottom raven black. One moment, madam, sensing her receiver rearing on the thunderclap about my ears, madam, I pleaded, wouldn't you rather see for yourself? Facially. Now, narrator is describing what type of his color is. Facially, I am brunette. My face is brunette colored. Means brunette means a woman with brown hair. So, facially, I am brunette. Now, the man had enough of her insensitiveness. He disregards all constraints of formality and mocks her outright, saying that he is not all black. So, his face is brunette type, but madam, you should see, but madam, you should also consider the rest of me. You should consider my rest body, not only my face. You should consider my all body parts. Palm of my hand, soles of my feet are a peroxide blonde. Palm of my hand and soles of my feet are not black, are a peroxide blonde. Are a chemical, peroxide means a chemical used to bleach something. So he says the soles of his feet and the palms of his hands are completely white. Friction caused gracefully, madam, by sitting down, has turned my bottom Raymond Blake. And due to friction, he says foolishly to that lady, madam, by sitting down, due to friction, my bottom has turned Raven Blake. Okay, so due to friction, my bottom has, but he is foolish enough to sit on his bottom, so it has been rubbed black due to friction. One moment, madam, and now he says, wait for a moment, madam, sensing, and now, but as he senses that she is about to slam the receiver, her receiver rearing on the thunderclap, but when he senses that she is about to slam the receiver on him, he asks her to, is she would like to see the color of her, his body. About my ears, madam, I pleaded. He pleaded, wouldn't you rather see for yourself? Now he asks her to, is she would like to see the color of his body herself, pleading her to at least see for herself, only to have the phone slammed on him. So the poet is satirical in this poem. He shows that there is racial discrimination in the whole world. I think you understood it. And now the poem is completed. Thanks for watching this video.